Next, we're going to talk about the performance. So if you can get that personnel in place, we work on the performance. Now, here's the issue, is it doesn't just happen sequentially like that. It'd be great if you walked in and you set everything up, and year one, I got all my personnel. And year two, now let's work on performance. Some things happen that way. This doesn't. So now we've got to work as we're trying to develop and get that right personnel with our performance. These are the things that we look for when we talk to our players and coaches about our performance. Give me a consistent structure with defined parameters. Again, I could probably do a parenting lecture on the same exact thing. And the best coaching advice I got from someone out of coaching was about this very thing. It was from Oprah. Not directly, obviously, she was, you know, on TV. And my wife was pregnant. Rachel was pregnant with our oldest. Anna Marie's now 8. And my dad told me, he said, hey, just a little piece of advice. When you start having kids and your wife's miserable and she's pregnant and it's, you know, whatever, May and it's hot, he said, even if you're happy, just when you're at home, pretend like you're just as miserable as she is and it'll make her life a heck of a lot easier. Good advice. So I cut out from work early one day and I went home and my wife, with her belly, kid's about a month away now, sitting on the couch. And Oprah is doing an episode on, you know, girls going bad, 16-year-old girls, you know, getting off the track. And she said something that resonated with me so strongly. She said, for a child, the threat of not having limitations can be debilitating. Boy, that hit home. And I know we all have kids, and they're going to say, oh, don't tie me down, or I want to do my own thing. No, no, no. They want the parameters. They want the definition. And if they have that definition, just like defined structures in your schemes offensively, defensively, and special teams, they're going to be able to act quicker within that because they know. The example I would use right here, if I was blind and I was on the edge of the stage, or if this stage, this room was dark, and I couldn't see where the edge of this stage was, I would be feeling my way as opposed to being able to know where the defined parameters are and move freely and quickly within them, setting your parameters. Number two, ability to recalculate. Something I think sometimes we don't understand nowadays because maybe the kids that we coach are similar in many ways to us when we played, but in some ways haven't had to just figure stuff out, right? You ask your team, hey, how many people just played sandlot football? Yeah, show of hands. And not a whole lot anymore. They're sitting inside doing this stuff. Or they have their scheduled time where they go from swimming to soccer to football to karate and all that type of stuff. But the ability to figure stuff out and recalculate, the analogy we use all the time with our team is these the TomToms, the GPS systems. I know we all have them in our phone right now. But I love that GPS system because I'm driving and I'm going to a high school and I've never been to that town before and I got my GPS up there and it says turn right in half a mile, and I get a little nervous, I'm not paying attention, and I turn right a block too early, right? What does the TomTom say to me? It doesn't say, you turn too early, you are now screwed, I will now shut down. It doesn't say that. What does that thing do? It automatically recalculates, hey, I got off track, that's my fault. Let's recalculate and figure out what the next best way to get back to our goal is. The ability to recalculate, it's becoming a lost art.